everybody. This is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBytes.com. Today, we're going to learn about America's 20th president, James A. Garfield. James A. Garfield was born in Orange, Ohio on November 19, 1831. James's father, Abram, died when he was still a baby. His mother, Eliza, later married another man, but James was never really happy with his new stepfather. James learned how to read when he was only 3 years old. Because of this and other reasons, James did very well in school. Even though his family was poor, James went to Hiram College and became the leader of a literary group there. In 1858, James finished his time at another school called Williams College. He had done especially well in Latin, reading, and sports. After college, Mr. Garfield became a preacher. He went around Ohio speaking out against slavery. He thought it was evil and that it should be stopped. Because of this, James Garfield is known as the Preacher President. Because he did so well in public speaking, Mr. Garfield went back to his old school, Hiram College, and became its president. One of Mr. Garfield's childhood friends was Lucretia Rudolph. They got married in 1858 and had 7 children together. While they were married, they experienced some hard times. Their daughter Eliza died when she was only 3 years old. However, after her death, James and Lucretia grew closer. In 1861, when the Civil War began, Mr. Garfield became a colonel in the Northern Army and led many men into battle. 2 years later, he was elected into the U.S. House of Representatives. While there, Mr. Garfield became the minority leader of the House. In 1880, the Republicans nominated Mr. Garfield as their candidate for president. He gave speeches near and at his home and won the election by a small margin. He defeated a Democrat named Winfield Scott Hancock, who had been a popular general during the Civil War. A man named Charles Guiteau had given speeches to help James Garfield get elected as president. Because of this, Mr. Guiteau thought that he should get a government job. However, President Garfield would not give him a job because he was refusing to grant any requests from his friends or relatives for government jobs. This made Charles Guiteau very angry. People later learned that Mr. Guiteau had become insane or mentally ill in his brain. He took revenge on President Garfield as a result, and assassinated him just months after he was elected president. Sadly, President Garfield died a few weeks later in September of 1881. We do not know what James Garfield would have accomplished as president. However, he did believe in ending patronage appointments, which means a president gives his friends government jobs. He also believed that the president should be allowed to make decisions on his own without the approval of Congress. An interesting fun fact is that James Garfield was very talented and could write with both hands. He could write a word in Latin with one hand while simultaneously writing it in Greek with the other. This is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBytes.com, and until next time, go learn your history!